Hey there! Today we're going to look at curves, one of the best filters in effects. There's so much you can do with curves. We'll go over some of the basics, and then I'm going to show you how you can really utilize it by just simply adding two curves and getting results from here to here. So you can use curves to even change colors or add background lights to your studio setup. So here's a relatively older image that I did at one of my workshops. This was shot on the Canon EOS 7D with an 85 f1.8 lens, and I still use that lens today. So pro tip, don't worry so much about cameras, they come and go, but lenses will last you a long time. So let's reset this image by right-clicking on it, and we'll select Reset Settings. Okay, so first thing to do is go into Develop by hitting the letter D. We'll go into Tone and Color and select a camera profile. With this older model, the 7D, the profiles actually weren't that great. So I'm going to use ON1 Portrait. Next, I'm going to press Option or Alt J to show the clippings. Let's take the exposure down, bump the contrast, and we'll take the blacks down until we just start seeing some of the dark black areas clipped. And right about there looks great. So next, let's go crop. I'm going to do the original ratio and just bring it in just a touch. So once we're happy with how the tone and color is and we have our image cropped, let's go into effects. Shortcut key is the letter S. Here we are in effects. Let's add a filter and select curves. So curves is a great tool. You can do matte looks by bringing up, kind of fading your blacks if you want. You could click on points to set them, lock them in place, and then kind of fade your blacks and it won't affect the rest of your image as much. You could brighten your image overall by bringing it up, darken your image by bringing the curve down. And while this is a typical use for the curves, I prefer to do all that in develops using the exposure controls, highlights, shadows, blacks, and white points. Both work great. It just depends on your preference. But I'm going to reset this curves and show you how you can use it to change colors. By default, it highlights all, but we can go into individual colors, the RGB, and set values for those. So let's take a look at getting it to pink to match her gloves. I just grab in the center and either go up or down to get to a color that I think is going to get closer to a pink. So I'll bump up the reds because there's definitely lots of reds in pink, and we'll go to greens and we'll just click on that and see if that's getting us closer. No, so we'll bring it down, and that is helping out. So let's bring that down a little bit. And next, let's get to blue. And I think this will help us get a nice shade of pink. Okay, so if we take it down, it's just getting more orange. So let's go up, and that's starting to get us into some shades of pink. And then we can always fine tune it. So let's go back to red and bring that. Let's go up just a little bit more. And there we have a nice pink. Right now though, it's applied to the entire image. We want it just to the background. So let's go up to mask. So we'll select background, paint in, and then hit apply. And then there's a few areas that we need to clean up. So we'll hit the letter N for our refine brush. We want to paint in. We'll use the method hair and branches to start with. And let's go over some of these areas. And for this area here, we'll just make the brush a little smaller, outline it, and that way it will paint in the area. Sometimes green screen does bleed over, so I'm just going to go over her pants. And we have a great selection. So that's how easy it is to change colors using curves. But let's go one step further and get the spotlight in the background. Since we already took the time to create a great mask on her, let's go ahead and right click on the mask icon and then hit copy. Then we can go up to add filter, select curves. So once the curves dialog box opens up, there are different styles. We'll select light and mids. But that applied it to everything. We're going to use that mask by right clicking on this icon and hit paste mask. So now all we did is brighten the background, but we still don't have that spotlight. But that's real easy by using the gradient mask, which is the letter M. Once we have that selected, again, you could do the drop down menu. We want to select the shape and we'll select edges. Then all we have to do is click where we want the spotlight to be. And we'll come up as an oval to start with. You can reshape it by grabbing any of the four buttons in the inner circle. We can make that smaller. If you click off of the four dots, then it will keep the shape that you have, so you can size it. And then on the outside is the feather, so we could sharpen that to make a spotlight or feather it to make it more of a diffused background light, like that. So that's how, using curves, we were able to quickly go from here to here. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, be sure to give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe so you can stay for future tutorials. Have a great one coming up once ON1 releases the new 2024.5. Lots of great masking options in that, with the Super Select is now on steroids. So stay tuned for that video. If you have any comments, be sure to leave them below. And until next time, keep shooting.